Hi, Billy.
Hey Bob, thanks for joining. How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, thanks. I appreciate you hopping on. It's also for me, it's a pleasure to meet you. I hear so much about you from Louis
Oh,
and Phil. So I feel like I know you just because I hear so much about you, but I've never actually had the chance to speak to you. Thanks for hopping on.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, cool. Well, let's jump into the introduction and so you can kick off your talk. So yeah, for those of you who don't know Bob Rocklin, he is the founder of another really, really amazing Shopify Plus agency called Code, based out of the Netherlands. Not only does he run an agency, but he also runs a Shopify Plus store in two different com or sorry, two different countries with his girlfriend. And fun fact about Bob, he actually developed his first vinyl web shop in 1999 on Apple Filmmaker Pro 3.0. And to be completely honest, I don't know what that is. But yeah, Seth, you've obviously been doing this for quite a long time. So without further ado, Bob is going to talk to you about why multiple storefronts on Shopify Plus is a good idea. And with that, I'll let you take it away.
All right. Hi, everyone. Let me share my presentation. So this is my screen. Hope you can all hear me. So welcome and glad to be here on this famous or beautiful DTX event, DTX event. I'll make a short introduction. So we are Code from Netherlands. We just launched a new logo. We exist since 2004. Did everything with the web, database, websites, iPhone apps, all kinds of stuff. We have two founders, like Wouter and me. There's the picture. 45 coders now and growing. And we have been a Shopify Plus partner since 2018. We were searching for focus for a long time because we did too many things, different things. We found this in Shopify. And since a year or so, also a little bit of Klaviyo. So I now want to take you to some questions. We have a lot with our merchants who want to maybe come from North America to Europe and sometimes do not understand how to do this. And I'm showing you how we do this. It's not per se the way you maybe should do, but we do it with our clients. And we also see a lot of other big brands of Shopify, even like Gymshark, do it the same way. So I think it's quite okay. Super short, this is our main office in Delft. This is the Netherlands. It's between The Hague and Rotterdam. This is our office building. It goes back a long time, very ancient history. It used to be an old printing house, so like paper printing and stuff. And the other week we found a very nice image. So watch this. We, of course, on the right, this is how we measure our revenue, right? We look at the Shopify and see how much we did. But on the left, you actually see how they did it in 1895. This is an image how they showed off in this park where we live now with the office, how much revenue they made. I find it's very funny to see. But let's get on to the business. So a lot of clients come to me and what we or to us and what we see many times is that they want, of course, rule and conquer the world with e-commerce. And we see some things that the starting and smaller merchants often say to us, we have a new brand, we're going to sell this t-shirt or this fragrance or whatnot. And they want to conquer the world. They want to directly sell to the United States, to the UK, Germany, Africa, whatever. And we see the more seasoned and experienced merchants, they come with a new brand or an existing brand, and they focus on one country, two countries, try to be a success 1, 2, 3 years, and then scale to next countries, like and slowly. And we think the sheet to right manner is the best. The most has the most success. So why multiple storefronts on Shopify Plus is a good idea? So not with one storefront, because you have, of course, many apps like Weglot, Lengify, stuff like that. But then you're focusing only on the translation. And we think And we know actually that localization is not only translation. It's only a very, very, very small part of to be successful in another country. So to pick up a few, this is by definitely not the whole list, but like taxes are different, payment methods, law is especially different. Currency, obviously, there's a lot of euro in Europe, but also different currencies in the Nordics. Demographics of buyer intent audience. So this is on what age and sex does your product resonate? Shipping providers are different. We even see different AOV. How to address people in your communication. For instance, we work a lot with German shops because we also have an office there, which is much more polite, which is actually super nice. Trust, how do you gain trust? Are there any trust badges you need? Social media is different. The law around social media is different. Product and market fit. We see funny things that in the Netherlands, people in fashion, more or less, that's actually true, go on orange colors, where in Germany it's more like gray, white. Convert the time of day and when to send your newsletter is also very, very different. Fun fact is that in the Netherlands, we see people opening their newsletters on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday morning when they are working. If we go to our neighbors, the Germans, they're actually much politer. So the Dutch people are, we think, shopping in their boss's time. And we see a spike in Germany, mostly at Friday evening. So they work Monday to Friday and end of day, they start shopping. And okay, the language is, of course, also very, very, very important. This is one of our clients' shop, and this is just a simple example from Google Analytics, where we have two Shopify shops, even five, but I picked two. And here already you see a huge difference, right, between the sex is more or less the same, but see the difference in age where people are buying. This is like huge, so it's very long tail, we say, in country B. Oh, sorry, in country A, it is all the way up to 55 and older. And here you can also tailor your site, like maybe you need bigger fonts, right? Or maybe you shouldn't advertise via Facebook to 25 to 34 year old people, where in country B you should definitely do that. So super important to keep track of your analytics here. Also, even another website we checked, this is with Rebuy, it's just some data, but even the average order value boost you can do with an app like Rebuy, this is an upsell app, is like more than twice as much, right? So also here you can focus more on upselling your products in country B, whereas in country A it might be very profitable or just a little bit. Then of course people come to us and then they say, hey, multiple storefronts, that sounds complicated and expensive. But most people maybe know that on Shopify Plus, you can do like 9 extra storefronts. So then you have already 10. And then they say something like this, I have to change my hero image or homepage like 5 times when I do 5 countries. But we think, yes, you should. You should do this and you should put in hard work if you want to earn some money and go for great conversions. And I took an example on the Shopify community, which is not ours, but it shows really nice how you should do this. So I think it's the same theme, it must be, but check this. This is Kupshe. And what you see here from clockwise, the US website is different, even in the colors of the banners or the base colors, that the German website on the top right and the French website on the top bottom left. And even the UK website, which is also English, of course, as the .com website, left top. Different products, see, different creative, all different stuff. And I bet they're very, very creative. Also, if you look carefully, you see they use a chat app in .com and UK, which is also different from the apps, from the sites in Germany and France. I think this is a very good example. This is one we have built. So Ring is the famous doorbell. The .com site is this is the .com site. And we don't pretend because we're a European agency, to know how the US market works, but we like to focus on the European market. But then we need many, many different sites. So the Dutch websites look like this, and then we build a lot of websites. Some are actually the same, but these are like, I think, like 10 or 12 websites for this this country alone, this company alone, just to focus in on the country. Another objection we get a lot, just checking the time, is how can I sync my products? Well, actually, this is kind of easy. There are two ways to do this, or maybe more ways, but two ways we use. So one is on the left side. If you are a smaller merchant and only a few SKUs, like 10 or maybe 100, we choose one of the Shopify shops you have as a mother, we call this, and we sync it. There are many apps, it's just an example, many sync apps, and you sync to the smaller countries, smaller websites. So, and if you grow bigger, or you have like maybe 1,000 SKUs or even more, the strategy more is to go for a professional PIM, product information management, and like Akinio. We work with Akinio, so a little bit of commercial things here. And then you put all Shopify shops at the same level, and Akinio will take care of your product information. So also that objection we can work around. Another objection, which is actually partially true, I have to buy each app like 5 times. That is true sometimes. So a few examples. Gorgeous, you only need to buy it once. This is super nice. So you can connect as many Shopify shops to your Gorgeous support system, support software. And you can nicely, like on the left, you can make a short list and maybe assign people only to the German website or Dutch website, which works super nice. Also, if somebody sends a request, you can automatically answer in the right language, which is super powerful. Other apps like Klaviyo, we like to work with, then you have multiple Klaviyo instances. And that is, I think, the easiest way, because it is possible, of course, to do a lot of if-else in your Klaviyo and then make sure you go to the right language, but you never know if you have one shop and it's a Gmail address. How do you know it's a German one or a Dutch one or someone from the UK? So it's much easier to set up different Klaviyo instances, and then you can switch between the shops. You can even copy flows and just change the language. Sometimes it's a bit more work, but in the end, it's easier, more pragmatic, and actually more successful. Another one, loyalty line, same. We like this also a lot. So you can also switch. They're also all tailored to switching with different Shopify shops. And we have very rarely seen an app with translations inside it. I still have to see the first one. So also like the labels in Loyalty Lion or in Klaviyo or any other app is always one language. So then it won't even work. And another thing is you want to use Loyalty Lion in the UK, but maybe you want to use Smile in Germany, which we see clients do. So all this freedom is super nice. Then I want an overview to all my shops. This used to be difficult, but slowly we always try to stay very close to Shopify. It comes more in Shopify Plus. I think most people know this view. And you see on the left side, users is now new, stores is new. And we're guessing and hoping that more and more will come to the left side, like customers, which is actually still separated. So yeah, we think this is really good. Another advantage, if you do your sales channels, they're also not multilingual or multi-region. So mostly we try to do different Facebook, different Pinterest, and different Instagram and Google for each shop. So you sync your German products or German language to your German Facebook, to your German Pinterest, and it makes it much easier if you do like this. O'Neill, we did O'Neill. So O'Neill consists of just one more case, consists of this is actually a very good strategy. Now 5 websites for Europe. We do only the European websites. And what they do, they build we have built a eu.o'neill.com, and there you can buy from, let's say, Denmark all the way to Italy, and also Germany, Netherlands, that doesn't matter. But for four countries which they find have a lot of traction and sales and conversion, we build a separate website. And we think this is very good strategy. So you're still selling in the whole of Europe, but only in the countries you feel traction and your product is picking up. Then you start a separate website. We see Gymshark do this. We see all these companies do it like that. So now they have like four extra, and maybe soon we will start Italy with it. If you then come on the EU website or other website, and there is a possibility that there is another website in the country you're visiting from, with IP check and so, right? We know it's not 100% secure, but it's like maybe 80 to 90% sure. And then we just not force them, but we politely ask, would you like to go to the Dutch shop? You could also be like maybe on holiday in the Netherlands and you just want to shop in the German shop. This works super well. Then I got I hope there's not still time for a bonus tip. Of course, if you save time doing it like we propose and other brands also do, you have a lot of time left. And this one is super nice. You can combine apps. We love to combine apps. So here we combined Octane, and we love the quizzes they developed. It's really nicely built. Then we combined this with Super Collections from Keymonix and with Klaviyo. So we like that apps do not only talk to Shopify, but talk to each other. That's super powerful. So what we've done here for several clients, we set up a super collection with Keymonix. And Keymonix is not like LimeSpot or Nosto putting in a snippet in your website, but it's just sorting your collections in Shopify. So there's no front end code automatically, like every 30 minutes. And then we send those super smart collections to Octane as a result from the quiz. And in this way, your quiz will be lively, because we see many people set up a quiz, but the results are always the same. But if you do it like this, your quiz results can be, if you want, different every 30 minutes. And then, of course, for retention, we send the results via Klaviyo. So I'll show you. So this is the backend of a Keymonix. And here you can just select a collection or even an existing collection in your shop. And then put in a lot of parameters. These are just a few where you maybe want to sell what you have a lot of stock, or high conversion rate, or high sales quantity, or the margin. You can push out of stock products, super smart. And what it does in the background, it's actually, I think, a brilliant idea. They manually sort your collections. So you could do it yourself, but of course that takes a lot of time. So they do it in a smart way. If you put this on, it will manually sort your collection every 30 minutes. So if this top product gets sold out, it moves other products up or gets more popular. And then in Octane, you have a dynamic collection, so the results will always be different. And then you have never the same quiz. And we see this is super powerful. And of course, if people do the quiz and then walk away from the screen, or they get a WhatsApp, or they go to the DTCX conference, we send them an email with Klaviyo or, of course, any other ESP. We send the results to the customer. And here you see where we started. This was the beginning was the simple collections. And now we use smart collections, and sales are ramping up like that. And it's set and forget, more or less. So there was like a bonus tip I wanted to share. Yeah. This was it. So I hope there's any Q&A, and happy to answer.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Bob. That was a really great talk. I personally learned a lot. We are at time, but we have one question that I want to get through real quick, because it was asked in the Q&A for you. It was from Peter. He asked you if Shopify was better than WordPress slash WooCommerce.
Oh, I don't want to take stance here, but what I like about Shopify the most is that it's SaaS, right? It's you rent the shopping cart, we always say, it's in the cloud, and you don't have to host it yourself. That gives you a lot of freedom of your weekend and evenings and stuff like that. Also for us, so we have built like over 200 shops, But we don't have to work in a weekend because Shopify will take care of the uptime and the security and so on.
It's awesome. Yeah. So yeah, I think most of the time, I think Shopify seems like it's going to be a better solution. But I dropped your email for Peter in the Q&A as well, if he wanted to kind of go into details with you on that. But yeah, thank you so much, Bob. Pleasure having you here. Pleasure finally meeting you. And yeah, we're going to bring out the next speaker.